Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, let's stand to our feet. Hallelujah. Let's fill this atmosphere with praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, let's cry out to Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's worship him. Let's bless his holy name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We magnify you, Lord God. We thank you, Lord Jesus. We bless your holy name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Jesus, you are great. You do miracles so great. And there is no one else like you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We worship you, Lord Jesus. We bless your holy name, Lord. We magnify you, Lord Jesus. For thou art worthy. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Let's lift up our voices. Hallelujah. Jesus, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You are a great God. Hallelujah. Jesus, beautiful rose of Sharon. Hallelujah. What a wonder you are. Hallelujah. Lion of the tribe of Judah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We bless you, Lord God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We honor you, Lord God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. At this time, hallelujah. Let us go to the throne of grace. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, each and every one of us. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Lord God, we bless you, Lord Jesus. We thank you, mighty God. Lord Jesus, we honor you this morning. We crown you King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. Mighty God, there is none like you, Lord Jesus. None compared to you, Lord Jesus. Lord God, you are the only true and living God. And Father God, we come before you right now, Lord Jesus, lifting up your name, Lord God. Hallelujah. In praise, Lord Jesus. Mighty God, we pray right now, Lord God, as we are about to begin our day's service, Lord Jesus. We pray, mighty God, that you will, Lord God, forgive us, Lord Jesus. We pray right now that you will purge us, Lord God. Cleanse us, Lord Jesus. Wash us as white as snow, Lord Jesus. Mighty God, I pray right now that you will anoint us from the crown of our heads, Lord God, to the sole of our feet, Lord Jesus. Mighty God, let your Shekinah glory fill this room, Lord Jesus. Mighty God, I pray right now that you will clear this atmosphere for worship, Lord Jesus. Let this atmosphere be on fire, Lord God. We pray right now in the name of Jesus. You will, Lord God, stretch forth your hands and you will touch us, Lord God. Mighty God, be a fence around about each and every one of us, Lord Jesus. Father God, help us, Lord God, to receive your words on today, mighty God. Mighty God, anoint the praise team, Lord God. Anoint, Lord God, the musician, Lord Jesus. Mighty God, even, Lord God, the man servant on today, Lord Jesus. We pray, mighty God, that you will use him, Lord God, in a mighty way, Lord Jesus. Speak through him, Lord God, and help us, Lord God, to receive each and every word, Lord God. Hallelujah. Mighty God, I pray right now, Lord Jesus, that you will mend every broken heart, Lord God. You will set every captive free, Lord Jesus. Break every chain, Lord God. Break, Lord God, hallelujah, every fetter, Lord Jesus. Mighty God, sprinkle your blood stains all over this place, mighty God. Father God, I pray right now that you will, Lord God, hallelujah, Lord Jesus, remove every spirit, Lord God, that is not of you, Lord Jesus, from amongst us, Lord Jesus. Mighty God, I pray, Lord God, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus, you will fill someone, Lord God, with the gift of the Holy Ghost, Lord God. And let the power, Lord God, of the Holy Ghost fall upon us, Lord Jesus. Mighty God, I pray right now, Lord God, hallelujah, that you will set someone free, Lord God. Deliver someone, Lord Jesus. In the name of Jesus, heal someone, Lord God. Whether it be spiritually, Lord God, physically, Lord Jesus, mentally, Lord God, hallelujah. I pray, Lord God, for a very special healing, Lord God. Mighty God, have your way in the service, Lord Jesus. And mighty God, we pray, Lord God, for unity, Lord God. We come against division right now, Lord God. We come against distraction, Lord God. In the name of Jesus. Father God, we cancel, Lord God, every suicidal thoughts, Lord God. Every spirit of depression, Lord God. Anxiety, Lord God. Hallelujah. Bipolar, Lord, depression, Lord Jesus. Everything that is unlike you, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, we cancel them right now. And we send them, Lord God, to the pit of hell in the name of Jesus. Mighty God, hear our cry on this day, Lord Jesus. Bless us, Lord God. Mighty God, we lift up everything and we present them to you right now, Lord Jesus. Mighty God, move in the service, Lord Jesus. Set somebody free, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Let your will be done on today, Lord God. Father God, we call everything done. As we look to you and we tell you thanks, in your mighty and holy name I pray. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. Let every heart say amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Our day's scripture will be coming from Psalm 99 in its entirety. In Jesus' name, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Psalm 99. And it reads, "The Lord reigneth, let the people tremble. He sitteth between the cherubims, let the earth be moved. The Lord is great in Zion. And he is high above all the people. Let them praise thy great and terrible name, for it is holy. The king's strength also loveth judgment. Thou dost establish equity. Thou executest judgment and righteousness in Jacob. Exalt ye the Lord our God, and worship at his footstool, for he is holy. Moses and Aaron among his priests, and Samuel among them all that call upon his name. They called upon the Lord, and he answered them. He spake unto them in the cloudy pillar. They kept his testimonies and the ordinance that he gave them. Thou answerest them, O Lord our God. Thou wast a God that forgavest them. Thou tookest vengeance of their inventions. Exalt the Lord our God, and worship at his holy hill, for the Lord our God is holy." Hallelujah. We thank God for his words in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Service is now in the hands of our praise team in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Hallelujah. It's a privilege and an honor to be in the presence of the Lord Jesus. It's such a privilege and an honor to be able to worship the King, the Master, the Savior of our souls. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Do you believe that God has a blessing for you today? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Can we position ourselves to receive what the Lord has for us? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. So I want you to help us all to worship the Lord together. Amen. Thank you, Lord. If you can stand, let's stand. If you want to clap your hands, clap your hands. Stomp your feet, move side to side, wave your hands. Whatever you got to do. The Bible says that everything that has breath, hallelujah, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, with the clapping of our hands, let's go right here. Hallelujah. Yes. Thank you, Jesus. Makes no difference what you're going through. You're gonna make it. God's gonna see you through. Hold your head up. Put a smile on your face. This is another test. It won't last always. So get ready.
Get ready
for your blessing.
For your blessing.
Get ready.
Get ready
for your miracle.
For your miracle.
Get ready.
Get ready
for your blessing.
For your blessing.
Get ready.
Get ready
for your miracle.
For your miracle.
I know you've been hurting deep down inside. Let me encourage you, it's gonna be all right. Troubles and trials, they come to make us strong. Keep on believing, you keep holding on. So get ready.
Get ready
for your blessing.
For your blessing.
Get ready.
Get ready
for your miracle.
For your miracle.
Get ready.
Get ready
for your blessing.
For your blessing.
Get ready.
Get ready
for your miracle.
For your miracle.
Get ready.
Get ready
for your blessing.
For your blessing.
Get ready.
Get ready
for your miracle.
For your miracle.
Sing, God got a blessing.
God got a blessing.
I believe God got a blessing.
God got a blessing.
Hallelujah. Turn to your neighbor and say, God got a blessing.
God got a blessing.
Come on, encourage your neighbor today and say, God got a blessing.
God got a blessing.
You don't have to worry. God got a blessing.
God got a blessing.
On this Sunday afternoon, God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
Hey, yeah. Sing, God's got a blessing.
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 With my name on it.
With my name on it.
God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
Oh, God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
With my name on it.
With my name on it.
God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
Oh, God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
With my name on it.
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 I believe.
With my name on it.
He's got a blessing in store for me.
With my name on it.
Do you believe?
With my name on it.
He's got a blessing in store.
With my name on it.
Come on and bless his name right here. Hey, yeah. I want you to tell your neighbor and say, God's got a blessing for you. Hey, God's got a blessing for you. Hey, yeah. Say, God's
got a blessing for you.
It's got your name written all over it.
God's got a blessing for you.
Do you believe that today? I believe that God's
got a blessing for you.
Come on, let's make it personal. God's got a blessing for
me. God's got a blessing for you.
Right standing with the Lord, you can
have
hallelujah.
It.
The Lord.
A blessing in waiting on the Lord.
I will wait.
Hallelujah.
On you.
Jesus, I will trust in you.
I will trust in you.
With all of my heart, I will.
I will trust in you.
Oh, I will remain.
I will remain confident in this. I will see the goodness of the Lord.
Come on, you want to declare. Hope.
yes, for we you. We set our hope for you.
We set our hope. Goodness of the Lord, I will remain
confident in this. I will see the goodness of the Lord.
I will remain
confident in this. I will see the goodness of the Lord.
I will wait on you. Hallelujah. Yes, I will wait on you. I will trust in you. I will trust in you. I will wait on you. Lord, I will wait on you. I will trust in you. Yes, I will trust in you. I will trust in the Lord. I will trust in the Lord. I will trust in the Lord. Till I die, I will trust in the. Said
I will trust
in the Lord.
In the Lord,
I will trust. Oh yes, God, hallelujah.
In the Lord,
till I die. I'm gonna trust. Trust the Lord, hallelujah, with all of my heart till I. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Trust in the Lord with all of thine heart and lean not to thine own understanding, but in all of thine ways, acknowledge Jesus. And he will direct our path. We got to let him do it. Hallelujah. We've got to let him do it. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Once again, can we give the Lord a hand clap of praise? Lifting up our voices. Hallelujah. Because he's worthy. Worthy are you, Lord. Worthy are you, Lord. Worthy are you, Lord. Worthy are you, Lord Jesus. Holy are you, Lord. Holy are you, Lord. Righteous you are, mighty you are, faithful you are, hallelujah. Nobody like you, Lord. There's nobody like you, Lord. Nobody like you, Jesus. Nobody like you, Lord. There's nobody like you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. He's done marvelous things. Hallelujah. He's a worthy God. Hallelujah. We put no other God before you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. What a privilege and an honor it is to worship the Lord Jesus. What a privilege and an honor. God, it is my honor to worship you, Jesus. It's an honor to praise you, Lord God. I thank God for the freedom to worship him. I thank him that I can openly worship the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I'm thankful that I can lift up my hands. I'm thankful that I can open up my mouth. I'm thankful that I can read my word. I'm thankful unto the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I used to hear it all the time growing up. I thank God when the old mothers used to get up in the church. They used to say, I thank God for the freedom to worship Jesus, because there are places that our people are banned from saying the name of Jesus, from opening up the Bible, from just giving God the glory. But we stand here in freedom to say, God, I thank you. Openly display the Lord. So openly call upon the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Unapologetically, because God is so good. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. He's a good God. He's a good God. Hallelujah. He's a good God. Hallelujah. He's a good God. Ha ha. Glory to God. He's a good God. Hallelujah. Lord, you're good. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I know God is a good God. Yes, he is. I know God is a good God.
Yes, he is.
I know God is a good God.
Yes, he is.
I know God is a good God.
Yes, he is.
I know God is a saving God.
Yes, he is.
I know God is a saving God.
Yes, he is. Holy,
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 holy.
faithful God. He's a faithful God. He's a faithful God.
For the announcements on today. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. We just want to take the time to welcome all our family and friends to Word of Life Church of Sumter. Hallelujah. We want to just say thank you for all of our guests that's here with us today. Thank you, Lord. just going to go through our weekly announcements. We have Monday night prayer and intercession at 7 p.m. And we also have our Tuesday night interactive Bible study at 7 p.m. Thank the Lord. We also have our Thursday night prayer call via Zoom at 8 p.m. Just some of our other announcements that we have for this week. The Healing and Restoration Crusade of Sumter that was planned on July 19th and the 20th. It has been postponed. So more information will be given at a further notice. Thank you, Lord. Today there will be no Word of Life Kids snack bar. Most likely we'll be picking up next Sunday. The Fusion Youth outing is coming this Friday. That will be happening at 6:30. Amen. All right, and we also have some free pantry items available in the fellowship hall today. So please go into the fellowship hall after service, and you are free to get whatever you want to our guests as well. Thank you, Lord. We would like everyone to remember to sign up for a prayer time on Wednesday and Thursday. The sign-up sheet is posted in the back. Please remember all our sick and shut-in. Our dear Elder Washington, just keep them in your prayers. Thank you, Lord. If you have any information that needs to be in the Sunday morning announcements, please see myself or Sister Hope. And the new schedule for the month of July has been posted in the back, and we also have copies right there in the back as well. Please govern yourselves accordingly. Can we prepare our hearts and minds for tithes and offering? Thank you, Lord. We have several ways that you can give. You can give by Giblify by downloading the Giblify app on your phone or device and search for Word of Life Church of Sumter. Or you can pay through Cash App, which is $WOL Church Sumter. Or by mail or in person like we all are here today. And all the information will be posted on the screen. And if you're watching via Facebook, it should be posted on your screen as well. As we always thank you for our faithful giving to this ministry, and we pray God continues to bless you and cause your cup to run over in Jesus' name. Can we go ahead and stand for our offering declaration on today? And please keep the building fund in your hearts and minds. That would be that blue bucket right here in the middle. Amen. Lord, as we give our tithes and offerings today, we commit our finances to you. Be in charge of our finances and use them for your purposes. May we be good stewards of all that you give us. We ask that we will live free of burdensome debt, and where we have been unwise, bring restoration and give us guidance. Give us wisdom to handle money wisely. Show us how to plan for the future. Help us to remember that all we have belongs to you and to be grateful for it. We pray that we will not be anxious about finances, but we will seek your kingdom first, my God. Knowing that as we do, we have all that we need according to your riches and glory in Christ Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. And you can follow the directions of our ushers on both sides. Amen, amen.
Oh, how wonderful, oh, how wonderful it is.
Jesus promised
he'll take care of me.
Oh, how marvelous,
oh, how marvelous it is.
Jesus promised
he'll take care of me.
Oh, how wonderful,
oh, how wonderful it is.
Oh, how marvelous.
Oh, how marvelous it is.
Jesus promised
he'll take care of me.
Oh, say, I don't have to worry.
I don't have to worry about the things ahead.
I don't have to worry.
I don't have to worry about the things ahead. I don't have to worry about the things ahead.
I don't have to worry.
I don't have to worry about the things ahead.
All I have to do is live right. All I have to do is live right. All I have to do is
believe in what he said.
I can call him in the morning.
I can call him in the middle of the night. promise he'll take care of me.
Praise the name of God. Can we just stand on our feet and just pray for the man of God today? Can we get on our feet? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Lord Jesus, hallelujah. We thank you, Lord God, just for today, Lord Jesus. We thank you for this very moment, Lord God. We thank you, hallelujah, for just coming in and fellowshipping with us, hallelujah, this far, oh God. We pray, Lord Jesus, that you will bless the man of God on today, Lord Jesus. Lord, we need to hear from you, Lord God. So we pray, oh God, that you will allow him to come forth, Lord Jesus, and deliver the word, oh God, withholding nothing in the name of Jesus. Because God, Lord Jesus, somebody needs to be encouraged on today, oh God. Someone needs deliverance on today, oh God. And we pray, Lord Jesus, that this atmosphere, hallelujah, will be conducive for your spirit to move, Lord God. Lord Jesus, we pray on today, oh God, that you will remind us, Lord Jesus, the ones that has been weakened in mind, Lord Jesus, that we are like a tree, hallelujah, that's planted by the rivers, Lord Jesus. And God, we cannot and we will not be moved, hallelujah. So Lord Jesus, we pray, oh God, that you will allow that word to come forth, Lord Jesus, and encourage our hearts, Lord Jesus, to let us know, oh God, that we can keep going, Lord Jesus, that you will be right there with us, Lord Jesus. We pray that you will have your way in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray and we thank you, oh God, in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, hallelujah.
Let's give God praise. Hallelujah. Come on, let's open up our mouth and give him praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Let's give God praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Supposed to be praising God. Y'all see how quiet y'all are? Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I just wish I had a church who would praise God for a moment right here. Thank you, Jesus. I wish I had a church who would praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, I wish I had a church who would open up their mouth. Hallelujah. And give God the praise. Hallelujah. I said give God the praise that is due unto his name. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I heard somebody say nobody can praise him like somebody who's been redeemed. I wish I had some redeemed people in the house today. Hallelujah. who know how to praise God like you've been redeemed and like you understand what that redemption means. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, open up your mouth. We ain't there yet. Open up your mouth. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Oh, bless the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hey, hey. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, I don't feel at liberty to move forward until we break through right here. Hallelujah. Come on, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, we need to break through. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We need to break through here. Hallelujah. I said we need to break through right here. There's a follow area right here. Come on here. We need to break it up. Hallelujah. So that God can plant whatever he want to plant in us today. Come on, open up your mouth and give God the praise. Come on, open up your mouth and give God the glory. Come on, don't you worry about your neighbor. Don't you worry about the person next to you. Hallelujah, it's time for you to come on into the throne room of God right now. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, bless his name. 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 Bless. I dare you to open up your mouth and break out in a praise right here. Hallelujah. Come on. Don't you let the devil take your praise. Hallelujah. Don't you let no circumstance take your praise. Don't you let no situation take your praise. Hallelujah. Open up your mouth and give God the praise. I say, open up your mouth and give God the praise. Because he's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, I will bless the Lord at all times. Come on, I will bless the Lord at all times. And his praises shall continually be in my mouth. Hallelujah. Come on, let your soul make a boast in the Lord. Hey. Come on, let your soul make a boast in the Lord. Come on, hallelujah, down from your belly. Let your soul make a boast in the Lord. And the humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Hallelujah. Glory. 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 And a rabashata. Yaramahaya. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, I need a spirit-led church right now. Come on, I don't need a church who's led by the flesh. I need a spirit-led church right now. Hey, hey, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Hande Shata. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The devil is defeated. I said the devil is defeated. I said the devil is defeated. God is exalted. Let us exalt the name of Jesus right now. Come on, exalt the name of Jesus for the victory right now. Come on, I said the devil is defeated. I said the devil is defeated. So let us exalt the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, what the devil had planned for you, hallelujah, is fail right now. Haya, Hina Bahasha. I said what the devil had planned out for you is failed right now. Hallelujah. You ought to praise God. You ought to praise God. Because the devil had a plan for you. I said, but it failed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Shia. I need a church right here. Come on. Don't let me pull on you. I need you to come on and flow. Hallelujah. Come on, hallelujah. The devil thought he had his way. Hallelujah. How? Come on, but we got the victory right now. I say we got the victory right now. We've got the victory right now. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hey, hey, Jesus. Everything the devil tried, come on, God made it fail. Everything the devil is trying right now, it's got to come to naught. Hallelujah, it's got to come to naught. Hallelujah. You ought to open up your mouth and bless him. You ought to open up your mouth and bless him. You ought to open up your mouth and bless God. You ought to open up your mouth and give him praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For no weapon formed against us shall prosper. Nothing that the enemy, none of his devices is going to work. Hallelujah. None of his devices is going to work. Hallelujah. None of his mental tricks is going to work on you. Come on, open up your mouth. Come on, every stronghold that he's trying to set up in your life, you've got the power to pull it down right now. I wish I had a church in here. Hallelujah. And the strong man that came to set up shop, come on, the stronger man is in the house today. And you ought to come on, hallelujah, and walk with the stronger man and bind the strong man even right now. We bind the strong man. We bind the strong man and we spoil all that belong to him. We spoil all of his goods. Hallelujah. We ransack his, my God, his camp right now. Hallelujah. And we take back from the enemy what he has stolen from us. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Higher, 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 higher. Yes, Lord. I told you, I'm tired of the enemy running over God's people. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I said, I'm tired of the enemy running over God's people. Thank you, Jesus. It's time for us to bind the enemy. Look, I'm telling you, bind him. Pull down the stronghold. Thank you, Jesus. Don't empathize with your captor. Glory to God. Don't refuse deliverance. Don't refuse rescuing. Glory to God. A lot of times people are not delivered because Amen. They hold on. Glory to God. And they empathize. Glory to God. With the captor. Glory to God. The captor started making them feel good. Come on, somebody. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. The captor started making them, amen, start speaking nice words to them. And they start feeling secure. Started feeling safe with the captor. Somebody shout, if you have a captor, you are a captive. You are still bound. I don't care how good it makes you feel. And that's why some people can't be delivered, because they feel good in their captivity. God come to set somebody free today. Lift your hands and let's worship Jesus. Come on, let a sound of worship come out of your mouth while your hands are lifted. Stop making excuses for your captor. How? Let God deliver you right now. Come on, come on, come on. When the rescuer comes and deliver you, he don't want to hear nothing about how good, amen, of a person that person is. Come on here. I don't want to hear nothing about the potential of your captor. Come on now. Come on and be delivered. Come on and be delivered today. Hallelujah. Come on and be delivered today. Matthew chapter 13. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Come on, open up your mouth and shout, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Matthew 13, verse number 1. The same day went Jesus out of the house and sat by the seaside, and great multitudes were gathered together unto him, so that he went into a ship and sat, and the whole multitude stood on the shore. And he spake many things unto them in parables, saying, behold, a sower went forth to sow. And when he sowed, some seeds fell by the wayside. Somebody shout, wayside. And the fowls came and devoured them. That's two different negatives right there in that same, over that one seed. It's the wayside, and then because it fell on the wayside, the fowls of the air came and devoured them up. Some fell on stony places, or upon stony places, where they had not much earth, and forthwith they sprung up because they had no deepness of earth. And when the sun was up, they were scorched because they had no root. Somebody shout, you need roots. And they need to go deep. When they did not have roots, the Bible says they withered away. And some fell upon thorns, and the thorns sprung up and choked them. Verse 8, but others fell into good ground and brought forth fruit. And some and hundredfold, some 60-fold, and some 30-fold. And final verse number nine. This is going to be, glory to God, the title of our message to you today, people of God. He that hath ears, let him hear. Who hath ears to hear, let him hear. Amen. I'm preaching a short time here into your hearing, a message entitled, He That Hath Ears, Let Him Hear. Amen. Put your Bibles down. Let's clap our hands and shout unto God real thunderously for a moment here. Hallelujah. Come on, shout to the Lord with a voice of triumph. Lord bless you. You may be seated in Jesus' name. We honor the Spirit of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And all of our elders and wives and all of our saints, brothers and sisters. Honor my wife, Lady Stephanie, in Jesus' name. All of our guests, we honor you in Jesus' name. The warning phrase, he that hath an ear, let him hear, occurs about 15 times in the New Testament. Each time this phrase is spoken by Jesus Christ himself. Revelation, after he gave a message to all the churches, he ended his speaking or his message, amen, with this phrase, he that hath an ear to hear, let him hear. Revelation 3 and verse number 20, the Bible says, behold, I stand at the door and knock. This is Jesus. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come into him and will sup with him and he with me. He that hath an ear to hear, let him hear. It is increasingly obvious when we read the scriptures, and especially verse, amen, in Revelation, when he finishes his message to the churches of Asia Minor. Amen. It's increasingly obvious that most church people don't have an ear to hear what the Spirit is saying unto the church. Jesus over and over and over again says, he that has an ear, let him hear. I want to pose two questions to you as I go into this message. One, what type of soil are you? Number two, what type of hearer are you? The major number of people in the church don't have an ear to hear. And the scripture describes these kind of people in James chapter 1. As forgetful hearers. As so says of God, when we identify what type of hearer we are, that will help us to determine what type of soil we are. How many know every one of us is a type of soil? Every one of us is a type of soil. And if we can identify what kind of hearing we are, we got to identify what type of soil we are. And Luke chapter number 8, verse number 11, the Bible says, the seed is the word of God. So today the Lord is casting out and he's sowing the seed of his word. And you are the soil that he's casting and he's sowing into. You've got to be the right type of soil in order for the seed of the word, amen, to be successful. Romans chapter 10, verse number 17. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Let's go over to James chapter number 1, amen, and that verse number 21. The Bible, amen, gives us these words. Wherefore lay apart all filthiness and superfluity of naughtiness, and receive with meekness the engrafted word of God, which is what? Able to save your souls. What does this really mean? It says you need to, amen, lay apart all filthiness and all superfluity of naughtiness. That means we ought to get rid of all the filth in our life. Come on. Amen. We got to get rid of all the uncleanness in our lives. And all that is wrong in our life, we have to get rid of it. Amen. He says, lay apart all filthiness. Lay apart all superfluity of naughtiness. All things, amen, amen, that you may be doing and you don't want people to know about. Glory to God. That's some of the things you ought to put away. Ain't that right? He says, lay it apart, lay it apart, lay it apart. And then he tells us in that same verse how to receive the word of God. He says we ought to receive the word of God with what? Y'all ain't following me. I said we ought to receive the word of God with how? We and James shout the one saints. Glory to God. Receive with how? Meekness the engrafted word of God. What does that word engraft mean? That means, amen, planted. That means it's got to be planted somewhere. The word has to be planted. Or the Lord is trying to plant his word in somewhere. Somewhere, somewhere he's trying to plant the word of God. Not on the ground outside, not on the carpet. He ain't trying to plant anywhere like that. He's trying to plant in the hearts of men his word, in the soil, which is the heart of man. The word of God, the Bible says, is the engrafted word of God. And when we receive it with meekness, the Bible says, then it is able to do what it's been sent out to do. And when it accomplishes, or when it germinates and when it brings forth, you ought to be saved. Amen. There ought to be a difference in your life. Somebody shout, there ought to be a difference in my life. When the word of God is planted in me, it ought to make a difference in the way I think. It ought to make a difference in the way that I walk. It ought to make a difference in the way that I treat my neighbor. And it ought to make a difference in the way that I treat my own self. Because the word of God is being successfully planted in my heart. Glory to God. Verse number 22, the Bible says, but be ye what? Doers of the word and not hearers only. Because if we become a hero only, what's going to happen? We do what? Come on, church. We are deceiving nobody else but ourselves. Ourselves. We're deceiving ourselves. Amen. Don't just come and listen to the word of God, but you must do what the word of God says, and you must actively and continually obey what the word of God says. There are precepts and there are principles in the word of God that we must put into action, and we must do it continually, not just on Sunday, amen, for the 2 hours that we're here in the sanctuary, but when we leave, we ought to put it into action. Glory to God. Hallelujah. When the drums is not going, and when the piano is not going, and when there is no corporate prayer meeting, we ought to put the word to action in our lives. On Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Somebody shout, do the word, do the word, do the word. We must, amen, do what the word of God says. Otherwise, you will only be fooling yourselves. This is what James tells us, amen. A lot of people think you're fooling God, or you're fooling the pastor, or you're fooling the saints. Amen. Glory to God. But tell somebody, you ain't fooling nobody but yourself. You ain't fooling nobody but yourself. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You ain't fooling God. You ain't fooling the pastor. You ain't fooling the people of God. Especially the ones who are full of the Holy Ghost. Come on here. You ain't fooling the Holy Ghost led person. Thank you, Jesus. You ain't fooling nobody but yourself. This is the way, amen, James tells us. When we leave the preaching and when we leave the teaching of the word of God on Sundays and on Tuesdays and hallelujah, on whatever day we receive, amen, the sowing of the word of God, and we go back to our own filthiness, go back to our own naughtiness. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I know that's an elementary word we use back in elementary word. Amen. Years. But the Bible says naughtiness. Glory to God. It's the same thing that's going to take you to hell. And he says naughtiness, we ought to do what? Put it away from us. And when we leave this kind of place where the word of God is being sown, and we go back to our sinful and unclean lifestyle, we ain't, amen, fooling nobody but ourselves. We become a hearer only and not a doer of the word. Verse number 23, the Bible says, "For if any man be a hearer of the word and not a doer, he is like unto a man beholding his natural face in a glass. And for he beholdeth himself, goes his way, and straightway, immediately, forgetteth," somebody shout forget, "what manner of man he was." You get ready for church. You look yourself in the mirror and you see, sister, you got a nice pink, amen, dress on. That's pink, right? Amen, pink dress. Glory to God. And you leave the mirror and you're like, what color dress I got on? You done forgot just that quick. And the Bible, James, amen, liken that unto someone who hears only the word and not a doer of the word. They look themselves in the mirror, which is the word of God. Come on, how many know the mirror is the word of God? If you want to know how you look, look in the word of God. If you need to know how you should look, look in the word of God. Come on. If you know, you need to know how you should act, look in the word of God. He'll tell you how you should look, how you should act, how you should react. So we get the word of God and we leave and we forget. And we go back to our own mess. He says, you are a forgetful hearer. You look in the mirror. And as soon as you leave your image in the mirror, you don't know what you look like. And that sounds like people today. They come to church. They look like the church. They sound like the church. But as soon as they leave the church, they done forgot who they are. And they forgot who and whose they are. You ain't fooling nobody but yourself. You done forgot what you look like. That's somebody who got what is that disease that you just forget? Alzheimer's? Or dementia? Huh? We just got memory loss. We don't know who we are. Huh? We forget that we holy. Come on. We forget that we lay aside every weight. We lay aside the sin that does so easily beset us. We forget, amen, that every day of our life is supposed to be a clean life. A kingdom life. To please the king. Glory to God. We leave and we forget the word. As soon as a trial come up in our life, we forget the word. As soon as the temperature, amen, get turned up in our life, we forget the word. Come on, somebody. Isn't that what the Bible says? The sun come up and it starts scorching the seed. Things happen in our life, and when we're supposed to go back to the mirror, we forget, and we start operating, amen, in a contrary way. You leave and forget the word. You fail to apply the word. You fail, amen, to let the word be planted into our hearts. And when the word is planted, it ought to have time to germinate. It ought to have time to let those roots go down deep. So that when the storms of life come, amen, you won't be plucked up. When the fowl of the air comes and land, glory to God, hallelujah, looking for food, looking for something to eat, it can't eat from you because your roots have been germinated and the seed has gone into the ground and it has germinated and now it's developing and you're growing in grace. Glory to God. I know this is the worst time, Elder Miller, amen, to plant grass seeds, but I just, glory to God, been driving around something, glory to God, doing a little bit of deliveries. And I keep seeing these people with these wonderful green grass. And every time I come home, I see my grass all eat out. And I see it is all dried out and it's suffering from the drought. And I say, you know what? I see these people got green grass. My grass don't have to be dead. Hallelujah. It don't have to be dead. Those people, amen, take pride in their grass. They're watering their grass. They overseed and they're doing all that good stuff to take care of their grass. And what am I doing? Why do I have dead grass? Because they don't get water until it rains. And when was the last time it rained? You don't even know. And I expect green grass with no water. Ain't nourishing the grass. And I expect it to be green like somebody else over there. Glory to God. And glory to God. So I went to Lowe's and I said, I'm going to buy me some grass seed. And I'm going to get a few sprinklers. And I'm going to put them in the yard. And I'm going to water this grass. And I want to see it come back to life. I know we're in the heat of summer. I know we're in a drought, but I'm going to do my best to get this thing revived. Glory to God. So, amen, I casted some seeds out there, and I started watering over and over and over. It only been 2-3 days. But I keep looking at that thing, just waiting to see something come up. But as soon as I cast it out, Brother TJ, the seeds, and I put the water on the grass, amen, it seems like the bird says, now it's our time to come swoop down. They came in I had never seen that many birds in my yard. They came and they swooped down and they started pecking at the seeds that didn't have a time yet to go down in the ground. I said, y'all better get from here. The seed got to go in the ground. Hallelujah. Come on, tell some neighbor that your seed got to go in the ground. And the birds came in and they sat up on the line, on the power line, waiting for me to go back in the house to do something. I sat right on the porch. You ain't getting this seed. You ain't coming to get this seed. Glory to God. And they came and they swooped down trying to get, amen, the seed. And that's what the enemy tried to do with each and every one of us. The Lord has cast it out, amen, the seed of his word. Amen. And the enemy, the Bible says that's what the foul is. It's the enemy of our soul trying to come and eat up the word that has been just sown out. We're not careful. We'll let the birds just come and eat up everything, amen, that the Lord is trying to do in our life. We'll let the flesh and we'll let the enemy, we'll let the fowls of the air come down and just take what belonged to us. Take what's supposed to go down in the soil. Glory to God. But somebody shout, I refuse, I refuse. I refuse to let any foul of the air. I want you to know the foul of the air, that's the enemy. That's what the Bible tells us. And we're going to get into it in Matthew chapter number 13. Amen. The foul of the air represents, amen, amen, the god of this world. Unclean spirits, unclean desires, unclean, my God, devils that want to come and take what God want to grow in you. How many know God want to grow something in you? Yeah, he want to grow something in your heart. He want to grow something in your mind. But as soon as that word goes out, something going to come up in your life and you're going to forget what the word came and said on Sunday and even on Tuesday. Come on, am I talking to anybody today? You know the enemy is going to bring something up in your life and you're going to forget that the Lord said on Sunday, amen, that all your needs I'm going to supply for you. Glory to God. You forget, he says, cast all your cares upon me for I cares for you. As soon as you hear that word, amen, you're going to go out from here and something going to smack you dead in your face. And you're going to forget what God said. And you're going to listen to what the enemy said. And that's something we so quick to listen to the devil than to listen to God. We so quick to receive a word from the enemy than to receive a word from God. Huh? We're so quick to let the word from the enemy germinate in us than to let the word, the seed of the word of God germinate in us. Glory to God. We fail to apply it. We fail to, amen, allow it to be planted in us. And we just let the enemy just have his way in us. It ain't time for him to eat my seed. You need to go somewhere else and eat that seed. You ain't gonna get it here. Glory to God. The Bible says, Hebrews chapter 4, verse number 12, for the word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit and the joints, amen, and of the joints and marrows. And it is, the word of God says, it is a discerner of the thoughts and the intent of the heart. Word of God is sown to save us, saints of God. It is the engrafted word of God which is able, amen, James says, to save our souls. Amen. It is sown to heal us. Hallelujah. The Bible says, amen, in Psalm chapter 107, verse number 20, amen. He sent his word and he healed us. Amen. And the word is also, amen, sown to deliver us. And in that same verse of scripture, he said the word came to heal us. The word came to deliver us. Hallelujah. Them from their destruction. Let me tell you, if you disregard the word of God, you're headed to destruction. If you disregard the word of God, you're not heading nowhere else but to your own destruction. He sent his word and he healed them and he delivered them from their destruction. And when we disregard this word, when we cast it off from us and we turn a deaf ear and we despise the word of God, tell your neighbor, don't you despise the word. I don't care how hard it gets. I don't care how bad it makes you feel. Hallelujah. Sometimes the word come to cut you. Come on here. Sometimes the word come, hallelujah, to bring asunder some things that are together. Some things in your life need to be separated. And the word is quick and powerful to go up in there, hallelujah, perform surgery in your heart. It ain't gonna always feel good and you're gonna need time to recover, but don't you get up off of that table. Glory to God. When God is trying to, amen, surge, hallelujah, and take some things out of you, don't you get off the table. That's why, amen, in the natural, amen, sometimes people got to go under for the doctor to do what they're supposed to do. Over to God. Y'all need to put some of y'all under. Don't bring you through until you know you've been delivered. Until you know you've been set free. We're despising the word of God because it hurts sometimes. And we're headed down, amen, a destructive road. Headed down the wrong direction. The word is sown not only, my God, to save us or to heal us or to deliver us, but the word of God is sown to wash us and to sanctify us and to cleanse us. Look over in Ephesians chapter number 5, verse number 26. Glory to God. Amen. And verse number 27, the Bible says, that he might sanctify, that he might cleanse it with the washing of water by the word. And verse number 27, the Bible says, that he might present it, a man to himself, a glorious church, not having spot, not having wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be what? Holy. Hallelujah. That it should be what? Holy. One more time. That it should be what? Holy and without blemish. Without blemish. That's what the word come to do. Try to get you out from that place of spotness and blemishness. How many know if your clothes could talk, amen, they would try to tell you, don't put me back in that washing machine. If they could talk, don't put me back in that. I know I'm dirty, but don't put me in that washing machine because it's a rough process for me to come out clean. And all you're going to do is just wear me out again. If your clothes could talk, but you tell that clothes, you got to get in here. You got to get in this washing machine. You got to let that thing throw you against the walls. And when you open that washing machine, the clothes be turned up against the wall. That's how the enemy want to do it. He wants you to, amen, that's how the God want to do you. He want to arrest you put you up against the wall and take all the uncleanness out of you. Take all the filth out of you. Take all the wickedness out of you. Take all the wrong thoughts out of you. Lord, arrest me. Hallelujah. So that I can come out clean. I can come out clean. And this is what the Lord want to do. He want to sanctify. He want to bring you out from among the world. Sanctify. That's what sanctify means. It means to be set apart. And he want to cleanse you. Amen. Anyone that needs to be cleansed, he must first be dirty. Glory to God. So if you dirty today in your spirit, don't run away from the washing machine. You qualify to go in there. You qualify for God to cleanse you. Glory to God. You can't cleanse yourself. You need God to cleanse you. Cleanse it with the washing of water by the word, that he might present a man you to himself, a glorious church. He don't want you to be spotted up. He don't want you to be wrinkled. Glory to God. He don't want any kind of such thing as this. He don't want a man you to have blemish, but he wants you to be holy. Holy. 1 Thessalonians chapter number 4, verse number 7. The Bible says, for God hath not called us to uncleanness, but he did call us. He called us unto holiness. Unto holiness. Let me tell you, saints, the enemy don't want people to hear the message of holiness. Don't want to hear the message of holiness. There's some things you got to put away. There's some things you got to lay aside. There's some things you got to come out, some places you got to come out from among. He says, come out from among them and be ye what? Who said it? I didn't say it. Saith the Lord, and I will receive you. You trying to be received while you're still in your mess. You got to come out from among them and be ye separate, saith the Lord. And then he says, I'll make you my sons and my daughters. Glory to God. I'm going back to James, and I'm coming to a close. Amen. He that has a ear, let him hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. But whosoever looketh into the perfect law of liberty. This is all liberty over here. Come on here. Glory to God. Anybody think you bound? It's liberty. This is the law of liberty. Says when you look into the perfect law of liberty and you continueth therein, he being not a forgetful hearer. See, one that's not a forgetful hearer, he's going to continue in what he received. But a forgetful hearer, glory to God, is going to go out and is going to forget what has been said. The Bible says he being not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the word. This man shall be, I want you to get this, this man shall be blessed in his deed. Y'all hear that? This man, a man that looks into the perfect law of liberty and continue in the word of God and is a doer of the work of God, he is a blessed man or a blessed woman. He's blessed. He's blessed. We ain't got time to be no forgetful hero today. Because the blessed man is the one that continues in the word and obeys the word and is submitted to the word. A lot of people right now ain't submitted to the word of God. They ain't submitted to the word of God. They ain't submitted to the word. If you submit it to the word, you'll sit and you'll let that word come down in your heart and you'll let it work. You'll let it work. Look at Psalm chapter number 1. First division of Psalms, should I say. James told us that this is a blessed man. How many want to be blessed? How many want to be considered a blessed man or a blessed woman? This is what you got to do. First division of Psalm, verse 1, the Bible says what? Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly. You got to separate yourself from ungodliness. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly. Nor standeth in the way of sinners. What's your surrounding? What's your environment? The word of God can't survive in every environment. Come on. The word of God cannot survive in every kind of climate. That's why I'm watching my grass now, because this is not the environment where I'm supposed to sow the seed. But I did it anyhow. I got to watch it closely, because it is ready to die. But there is an environment that the seed of the word of God cannot, amen, cannot be progressive in, and cannot be successful in, and cannot thrive in. And there is, amen, an environment where the opposite can happen, where it can thrive, where it can take root, where you can be blessed like nobody else. Where, come on, where you can rise above all your issues and say, the Lord will provide, the Lord will take care of me. Where you can look back at the devil, look him dead in his face like Jesus said on Tuesday night, it is written, get thee behind me. That's how we know. That's how we know the word is germinated in us. When we can recognize the devil, we can recognize him moving, and we tell him the devil is a liar. The Bible says, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. Verse number 2, the Bible says what? But his delight is where? Is in the law of the Lord. Tell somebody, that's the word. Hallelujah. His delight is in the law of the Lord. Uh-huh. And in his law, or in his word. All right. His word, we're supposed to meditate day and night. Come on. We're supposed to have a delight in the word of God. How many is delighted to hear the word of God? How many is looking for the opportunity to highlight a scripture? To highlight a word. Say, Lord, I that just spoke to me. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law doth he meditate, huh, day and night, not just fastly just reading over, but we got to meditate on that thing day and night. And the Bible says, and he shall be like a what? Like a tree planted by the rivers of water, that bringeth forth his fruit in his season, and his leaf, look at this, also shall not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. The Bible says he is blessed in all his deeds. Everything that he do is going to prosper. So the enemy knows, amen, how to distract us from the word of God. The enemy knows how to distract us. I sit here, and sometimes I sit over there, sometimes I'm preaching, and I'm looking over the congregation as the word of God going forth, and some people got heavy eyes. Huh? Not being received. You can't receive nothing sleeping. Been up all night, and I ain't know what you've been doing. As soon as it's time to receive the word of God, I'm sleeping. His delight is in the law of the Lord. When it's time for the word of God to be sown, we ought to be perked up. Because there is a way we ought to receive the word of God. The Bible says, receive it with the spirit of meekness, the engrafted the word of God. Not with a frown on your face. Huh? Not with a spirit of, I wonder when he's going to close. With a spirit of meekness, humility. Glory to God. Glory to God. Oh, he talking about me. I ain't talking about you. I'm casting a seed. I'm casting the word of God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. That's the one that's going to be blessed. Don't expect to be blessed if you don't love the word of God. Because if you get in the word of God, he'll tell you how to be blessed. Ain't that right? He'll tell you how to bless, how to be blessed. He'll tell you how to think. He says, think on these things. Huh? If there be any virtue, if there be any praise, think on these things. What we've been thinking on. What we've been meditating on. Huh? That's why we're in a depressed spirit. What has our mind been wandering on all that time? And even while we're in the church of God, the minds are wandering from here to there. Sleepy, eyes are heavy. Glory to God. Texting and scrolling on the internet while the word is being sown. Glory to God. Verse number 26, James chapter 1. If any man among you seem to be religious and bridle not his tongue, but deceiveth his own heart. See, the people think you're deceiving everybody else. You ain't deceiving nobody but yourself. Glory to God. When you get down and pray by your bedside and pray until you pray through, you're going to help yourself. Come on, somebody. Come on, church. When you open up the word of God and you let it go in your heart, it's going to help you in your life. And when you don't do it, it hurts only you. Because while you're in prayer, God tell you, don't go there today. And you missed your prayer appointment with God and you went there anyhow. And you find yourself in destruction. You find yourself in the wrong situation. Why? Because you missed your appointment with God and he was going to tell you, don't you go there today. I know it's in your routine, but don't go there today. Come on, I wish I had a church in here today. You missed your prayer appointment with God because you had something else to do. And God was going to tell you, go over here because I'm going to bless you that you're going to be able to pay your bill with this. And you missed the prayer meeting with God. And you went somewhere else and when that person over there had your blessing. He says, you deceive yourself. You're religious. If you seem to be religious, then we got a lot of religious people. But they ain't right standing with God. That's why we ain't getting nothing from God. Any man seen to be religious and bridle not his tongue. How many know religious people who the meanest people on earth? You go to church every Sunday, but I curse you out tomorrow too. The Bible says that man's religion is vile. If you cannot bridle your tongue, you don't have self-control. Come on. If you can't stay holy, if you can't let the word go down in your heart, your religion is vain. He said, that man's religion, that ain't God's religion. That man's religion is vain, and you're fooling nobody but yourself. It's time to get back in the right standing with God, saints. Look at verse number 27. Pure religion and undefiled before God and the Father is this, to visit the fatherless and the widows in their affliction. And look at this. He says, and to keep himself how? Unspotted from what? From the world. If your religion don't include that, your religion is vain. And we living in a time right now where people want to do everything that they want to do and still, amen, claim God. Still want to claim God, but the Bible says you got to keep yourself unspotted from the world. And it seems like people seem like they're more anointed when they look worldly. When they sound worldly. You ain't more anointed when you spotted by the world. Ain't more anointed by putting, amen, a ring in your nose. You ain't anointed, more anointed because of that. We gotta listen, say we gotta be careful. Your religion is vain. Hallelujah. And it is defiled. But Jesus says you got to keep yourself unspotted from the world. Love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. For the lust, my God, hallelujah, all that is in the world is the lust of the eye, the lust of the flesh, and the pride of life. Come on. Don't you love the world? Stop loving the world. Come out from among the world and be ye separate. This world and all of its deeds is going down. It's going to be destroyed. You don't want to be left here when God come doing his destroying. You want to be found in the kingdom of God. Thank you, Jesus. Keep yourself unspotted. Keep yourself uncontaminated. Keep yourself unpolluted from this world. Peter told those people on the day of Pentecost, save yourself from this untoward generation. Don't you go down, amen, with those sinners. Come on here. Don't you walk with them. Don't you sit with them. Come out from among them so I can plant you. My God, by, amen, the rivers of water. He said, I'll be your supply. You don't need to go nowhere else for your supply. I am the source of your supply. Thank you, Jesus. I'm the source of your supply. Glory to God. You know, we can tell where your heart is, glory to God, when we see where your money going. Come on, somebody. You can tell where your heart is because you can't serve, amen, mammoth and God at the same time. You can use your money to worship God, but you don't need to be serving that money. Thank you, Jesus. We got to be unspotted, saints of God. We got to be uncontaminated. This is what the world want to do to us. They want to spot us up, want to contaminate us, and want to pollute us. Glory to God. And I'm closing with this. Matthew chapter number 13. Verse number 16. We're going to jump down there. Amen. Verse number 16. All right, let's talk about that blessed person again. This is the same blessed person. What did the Bible say? But blessed are your eyes. Why? You better give God praise for eyes that can see. And I ain't talking about physical eyes. I'm talking about spiritual eyes. Blessed are your eyes, for they see. Come on. And your ears, for they hear. Come on, clap your hands and give God praise right here. Verse number 17, the Bible says what? For verily I say unto you. Come on. Uh-huh. And they have not seen it. Look at this. And many prophets and righteous men desire to see and to hear what you're seeing and hear about the kingdom of God. And they did not hear it. They desired to hear it, but they did not hear it. But you're sitting in the kingdom of God today. Come on. Repented of sin. Come on. Baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Filled with the gift of the Holy Ghost, and you're in the kingdom of God, and men that were righteous wanted to hear about this. Didn't have a chance to hear it. Glory to God. But you hear it every day. That's why he says, blessed is the man that heareth. You got ears and you can hear it. Come on, you're blessed when you can see. Come on here. The enemy had you blinded at one time, but you ought to look at your neighbor. I said it and say, I once was blind, but now I see. I once was deaf, but now I can hear. That's an amazing grace. Glory to God. And the Bible says what? Verse number 18. Hear ye therefore the parable or the sower. When anyone heareth the word of the kingdom and understandeth it not, then cometh who? Now in the verses prior to that, he said the fowl of the air. Now the Bible says he is the wicked one. He catches away that which was sown in his heart. This is he which received seed by the wayside. But he that receiveth seed into stony places, the same is he that heareth the word. Come on. And anon with joy receiveth it. Come on, God. You listen. It don't matter that you dance and shout about the word. But what the Bible says. And yet hath he what? Not root in himself. Just because you're dancing and shouting don't mean you got root. You ain't got no root in yourself. But you endure just for a while. Ain't that what the Bible says? And but when what comes? When tribulation or persecution comes or rebuke, huh? Or something that make you, amen, glory to God, make you feel bad in your spirit. When any of those things come, what happens? Because of the word, by and by he is offended. Verse 22. Uh-huh. He also that receiveth seed among the thorns is he that heareth the word. Uh-huh. And the care of this world and the deceitfulness of riches choke the word. Come on. And he becometh unfruitful. Verse number 23, final verse, and the Bible says what? This is where we all should be. What kind of seed are you? What kind of soil are you? Huh? How is your hearing? Those are two questions I asked you before, amen, we got into the message. What kind of soil are you? But he that receiveth seed into the good ground, come on, he heareth the word and understandeth it, which also do what? Bear fruit and bring it forth. Oh, God, I praise you. Some 100-fold, some 60, and some 30. Clap your hands and give God praise right here. What kind of soil are you? Huh? I'm talking to you. What kind of soil are you? Do you understand the word of God? Huh? Do you have root within yourself? Is the word of God taking root in you? Are you bearing fruit? Are you bringing forth? This is what we need to ask ourselves. He that hath an ear, let him hear. God want to present us to him, a glorious church without spot and without any such blemish. He want to present us to him. You don't want to get nothing out of the store that got spots on it. You don't want nothing out of that store that got mildew on it. Huh? And if you get home and you find it, you're going to want a refund. How you expect God to receive you when you all spotted up with the world? He says, keep yourself unspotted from the world. Keep yourself unspotted from the world. Wherefore lay upon all filthiness and superfluity of naughtiness, and receive with meekness the engrafted, or the planted word of God, or the word that is sown. Receive it with meekness, amen, which is able to save your soul. You can't receive the planted seed of the word with a callous and hardened heart. That thing got to be broken up. And let me tell you what, that was one of my mistakes when I casted out the seed in my yard. I didn't break it up. I didn't break the ground up. Huh? I didn't break it up. I just expected it to go deep. And the ground was hard because of the summer heat. When I walked over the grass, I could hear it crackling. And I expected the seed to go and go between that and find its way to the root, or to the soil. I was supposed to get out there first. And I was supposed to break up the fallow ground. Come on, I was supposed to get some whatever tool it is, and I was supposed to poke some holes in the ground so that it could have room to breathe. And I didn't do nothing of that because I just wanted my grass to look like somebody else's grass. And say to God, I want us to stand right now, and I want us to break up the fallow ground. And I want us to let that word go down. I want it to go down deep so that when the water, amen, come and the seed come, both is the word of God, the seed and the water and the spirit of God. When it comes, it can go deep down in you so that when the trials of life, when the tribulation comes, when the cares of life present itself to you, glory to God, you have enough root in you. You have enough word in you where you can say, amen, I cannot be unrooted. I can be uprooted. I can be, glory to God, hallelujah, moved from this. I am settled. hallelujah, I am rooted and I am grounded. The Bible says we ought to be, amen, unmovable in areas of our life. Sometimes, amen, we are movable because of our roots that are not going deep. He that has an ear today, let him hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. Hear what the Spirit is saying to you collectively, and hear what he is saying to you individually. The Bible says in Hosea chapter 10, verse 12, sow to yourselves in righteousness, reap in mercy. Break up the fallow ground. Break up your fallow ground. For it is time to seek the Lord. Hallelujah. The Bible says it is time to seek the Lord. But you must first break up the fallow ground. Amen. And then he says, till he come and rain righteousness upon you. The time is now to seek God. Can we lift our hands all over this house? And let's just lift up our voices right now. And whatever seed is being casted out right now, I want you to just let it go down in your spirit. Hallelujah. I want you to let it go down. Come on, hallelujah. And if you need to break up the fallow ground before that seed can go down in there, I want you to open up your mouth. And I want you to command that fallowness, hallelujah, of the hardness of your heart. I want you to command it to be, amen, broken up so that the word can go and do what it came to do, so that it can accomplish what it's been sent out to do. The Bible says, amen, the word shall be accomplished, and it is not going to go back to him until it accomplished what has been sent to do in your life. Come on, open up your mouth, saints. Come on, open up your mouth, saints. Come on, I feel a very heavy spirit. Spirit, the presence of God right here. And I pray tonight, I pray today, glory to God, that we have an ear to hear what the Spirit is saying. Come on, hallelujah. Open up your mouth. 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 Hallelujah. And sow unto yourself righteousness. Come on, we're in the kingdom of God. The kingdom is not meat. The kingdom is not drink. But the kingdom is righteousness. The kingdom, hallelujah, hallelujah, is joy in the Holy Ghost. Come on, the Lord want to renew your joy. The Lord want to renew your peace. You ought not to be worried about nothing. You're in the kingdom of God. And the kingdom has peace in it. The kingdom has joy in it. The kingdom is about righteousness. Sow unto yourself righteousness. Higher. Come on, I need everybody to put your mind on Jesus. I need you to go into a prayer mode right now. I need you as the people of God, the church of the living God. Hallelujah, begin to pray. Let it come from your spirit. Let it go. Let it be higher. Let it come from your heart. Come on, in the name of Jesus. Let it come from your belly. Come on, blessed are you that have eyes that you can see, that have ears that you can hear. Come on, Jesus. Come on, Jesus. You're in the kingdom of God today. Hallelujah. And the Bible says, go and preach the gospel of the kingdom. And when you have preached, he said, heal the sick. Come on, raise the dead. Cleanse the lepers. Whatever you need in this house right now, why don't you go? Why don't you get it now? Hey, in the name of Jesus. 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 us. Come on, that's it. Open up your mouth. Open up your mouth. Come on, let that seed go down. Let that seed go down. Don't let that follow the air land and try to peck at that seed. Higher, higher. Come on, rebuke the enemy. Bind the enemy right now. Bind the enemy right now. Bind the enemy right now. Come on, you need to shoot off the fowl of the air. You need to shoot them off now. Because he want to take the seed that's been sown. He want to take the seed that's been sown. But you want to tell every devil in your life, you are a liar. I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. You ain't going to get what the Lord sent for me to have. Oh, yellow, yellow, yellow. Yellow, yellow, yellow. That's it. Come on, saints. Open up your mouth. I need to hear. I need to hear the people of God. I need to hear the people of God. I need to hear a sound in this place. I need to hear the sound of worship. I need to hear the sound of prayer. I need to hear the sound of supplication. Come on, I'm opening this altar right now. Come on, there's some fallow ground that need to be broke up. You can break it up right now. I'm opening up this altar right now. If you have an ear to hear, I need you to come to the altar and listen to what the Lord want to say to your spirit. Come on, if you have an ear to hear, if you have an eye to see, let the Lord show you what you need to see. Anamasaya, Hayamasa, Hanalamahaya. Come on, Nanamashanda. Come on, saints, open up your mouth. Kanadalamahosaya, Hallelujah, Shanda. Come on, the Lord has opened up our ears now. Oh, speak to our heart, Lord. Hey, we need to hear from you. Hey, hello, Jesus. Open up our hearts, Lord. Come on, saints, I need you to pray. I need you to pray. Come on, Lord, open up my eyes. Lift up the scale off of my eyes. I want to see you high and lifted up. I want to hear your voice. I want to hear what you're saying to me, Lord. I want to hear what you're saying to me, Lord. Come on, I bind every devil. I bind every devil. You are the blessed of the Lord. Come on, because you can hear. Hiya, you're the blessed of the Lord. Because you can see. Come on, righteous men wanted to hear and see this. The prophets of old wanted to hear and to see this. Oh, but you're blessed today because you can see it and you can hear it. Sometimes you need another examination. You need to see. You need an eye examination. You need a hearing test. But God want to let you know that your hearing can be approved today. It can be, hallelujah, hallelujah. It can be, thank you, Jesus, improve. Your seeing can be improved today in the spirit. Hanarabashata. Hikandalabahaya. Hira boho shata. Hikanda rabahaya. Hayaya. You might not know the words to say. But the Spirit of God in you, He knows your infirmities. And He knows exactly what to pray for. Why don't you tap into the Holy Ghost? Why don't you tap into the Spirit of God? Why don't you tap into the Spirit? Why don't you tap into the Spirit realm and let the Spirit begin to lead you in prayer? Open up your mouth. 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 Hallelujah. The fowl of the air trying to find a place to land, trying to take your seed, but I bind him now. I bind the enemy now. I bind the strong man in the name of Jesus. I bind the strong man. That seed gonna go down in there. That seed of the word is gonna germinate. Come on, you're gonna delight in the word. You're gonna delight in the word. You're gonna delight in the word. And you're gonna be like a tree. Planted by the rivers of water. Receive the word. Receive the word with a spirit of meekness. Receive it with humility. I find every strong man, every stronghold. Anything that causes you not to hear clearly, I bind now in Jesus' name. Anything that's causing you not to see clearly, I bind in Jesus' name. He that have an ear to hear, let him hear. Let him hear. Come on, pray, pray. I bind the enemy now. Jesus. Come on. I'm running every foul away now. Come on, saints. We ought to run every foul away now. Don't you let them take that seed. Run them away. Come on. Come on. We got to run. We got to save the seed. Shataha. We got to save the seed. That's it. Pray. Pray. Save that seed. Let it go in your heart. Don't let the devil steal it. Don't let the tribulations of this world. Don't let the cares of the world steal it. Hold on to the seed. Hold on to the seed. He that have an ear. Here. Open up your ears. Open up your ears. Come on, everybody praying. Jesus. Oh, God, want you to see something. You got to go in the spirit. God want you to hear something. Down in your soul. Down in your spirit. Down in your belly. God is speaking something to you. And you can't hear it until you go down in there. You ain't gonna be able to see it until you go down in there. Go in the spirit. Hear what the Spirit says. Hear what the Spirit says. He says, lay apart from you all wickedness. Lay apart from you all filthiness. You hear the word of God? Lay apart from you all superfluity of naughtiness. Hey! Jesus. Open your mouth. I tie the enemy now. Ha! Shut up. I bind the enemy. The strong man. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on. Hallelujah. Every foul that want to spot you, want to contaminate you. Hey! Want to make you filthy. In the name of Jesus, I bind it now. I bind it now. I bound it now. Let the word wash you. Let the word sanctify you. Let the word cleanse you. Come on, Jesus. Don't let the sun scorch you. Don't let the elements of this world, don't let it burn you up. Oh, but get the nutrients of the word. Get the nutrients of the water. The washing of the water of the word. Come on, water every day. Water it every day. Water it every day. Water it every day. Water it every day. Don't miss a day. His delight is in the law of the Lord. And in his law does he meditate day and night. I bind the strong man now that's trying to mess with your mind. Come on, I shoot and I run away every fowl of the air. That wicked one that desires to have you, that desires to sift you as wheat. Hallelujah, I pray for you. Oh, that your faith fail not, even now and forevermore. Even when the time comes, hallelujah, when it's time for you to move out, even when it's time for you to live your own life, I pray now that you will solidify now, solidify now, solidify now. Solidify now. Make yourself solid. Break up the fallow ground now so that you can live, so that you can be blessed, so that you can know that you are my God. Not just my mother's God, not just my father's God, but you are my God. Come on, just begin to open up your mouth. Open up your mouth. Let that word go down. Let that word go down. Let that word go down deep, deep, deep down. Come on, don't let it stay on the don't let it stay on the surface. Let that word go deep down. Come on, let that deep, let it go deep, because the enemy is working. The enemy is waiting to come down to steal away the word. Come on. Stay in the kingdom. Stay in the kingdom. Hateko kosha. Hey, shopoka. Shao Mahaya. Make up in your mind. Make your mind up. Make your mind up. Jesus. 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 Come on, saints. Don't stop praying. Come on. Come on. Let's go to another level. Turn it up. Turn it up. Turn it up. Turn it up. Ho. Hey! Let that word go down. Let that word germinate. Let that word begin to develop. Oh, Jesus! Much work to do. There's much work to do. There's much work to do. There's much work to do. Come on. Come on, the enemy's been stealing. He's been stealing what you've been hearing. And as soon as you walked out of here, the enemy's been stealing from your heart. Hey, come on. He's a fowl. He's an unclean bird sitting on the power line. Trying to come, waiting for the opportunity to steal away the word from your heart. But I speak to you by the word of knowledge now in Jesus' name. Don't you hear what the enemy says to you? Close up your ear to the enemy. Close up your ear to the enemy. Close up your ear to the enemy. And hear what the Spirit saith unto the church. Hear what he's saying to you. Hear what he's saying to you. Come on, there's a direct word for your life right now. There's a direct word from heaven right now to your spirit. Go down in the spirit. Hear what the Spirit of God is saying. There's a direct word that God sent to you here today. You need to hear it. Remove every distraction. Break up the fallow ground. Let that word go down in your spirit. Come on, open up your mouth. Open up your mouth. Open up your mouth. You're going to be able to hear it in the spirit. Not in your flesh. Not in your flesh. You're going to be able to hear it and see it in the spirit. Come on, Jesus. Hey. Jesus. Come on, church. Come on, begin to cry out to God. Come on, begin to cry out to God. I want to present you faithful. I want to present you holy. I want to present you spotless. Oh, I want to present you to myself. Hey, without spot. Somebody begin to pray. Come on, in the Holy Ghost. Build up yourself. Build up yourself. Come on, build up yourself. 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 Come on, you got the power to build yourself up. Yeah. You got the power to build yourself up. Ah, there's a spirit in you. Jesus. Come on, I come against every lying devil. I come against every lying spirit. I come against every lying devil. Come on, he says, if you have an ear, you need to hear it. Don't just be a hearer, but be a doer. Look for a way to activate the word. Look for a way for an opportunity to continue to obey the word of God. Then you will be blessed. 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 Come on, hallelujah. Hallelujah. I know you've been through a lot. I know you've been through a lot. Oh, but you got to obey God. You got to hear the word of God. Hata. Himamamashaya. How? You ain't blessed until you obey God. You ain't blessed until you obey God. You ain't blessed until you obey God. Come on. Come on, let it go down. Let it go down. Come on. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, let it go down so you can hear what God is saying. Come on. Come on, let it go down in there. Let it go down in there. Come on, let it go down so God can speak to your man. Speak to your inner man. So he can speak to your inner man. So he can speak to your inner man. Come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. The devil is a liar today. Come on, the devil is a liar today. Come on, let's pray, let's pray, let's pray, let's pray. Let's pray, let's pray, let's pray. Let's pray. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, there's a word of knowledge here today. There's a word of wisdom. There's a prophecy here. Ah, there's a word of utterance here. Come on, open up your mouth. For his spirit speaketh expressly. Hey! Thank you, Jesus. Protect your seed. Protect your seed. Ho! Ho! Come on, there's a seed that God has sent for your life. You need to protect that seed. Come on, there's a seed, my God, of deliverance. Deliverance, there's a seed of deliverance for your mind. Don't let the enemy take it from you. Come on, don't let the enemy take it from you. I don't care what you go through on a daily basis. Don't let the enemy take it from your mind. Come on, there's a seed directly for you. Come on, personally for you. Protect your seed. Protect your seed. Break up the fallow ground so the seed can go down. Break up the fallow ground so that seed can go down in there. Don't let it rest upon the surface. Break up that ground so it can go down in there. It's not always comfortable when your ground is being broken up, when it's your ground is being tilled. It's not always a comfortable thing, but it got to happen. It's 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 got to happen. Hiya. Oh, come on. Come on. Hiya, hiya. Come on, can I get a few prayer warriors? Let's pray with our sister right here. Come on. The Lord is breaking up some things right here. Yes, 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 yes. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God. Glory to God, glory to God. Come on, if the enemy can swarm in, come on, the people of God can swarm in. Shanda!